My colleagues, we come to this chamber to have policy debates, and we've done that with vigor several times over the years. But there's a difference between mainstream policy debates that we engage in as colleagues across the aisle from one another, and a difference when we're dealing with an action that is so beyond the pale, so historically unprecedented, so un-American that we are compelled to action. And I believe we are now facing one of those situations. Anyone who has picked up a newspaper, watched the TV, or gone on their iPad in the last several days has noticed that the results of an executive order issued by President Trump have led to an incredible, organic, and spontaneous opposition all across this land. Tens of thousands of people taken to the streets, rallying to their local airports to make sure that people who are legally entitled to enter this country, have been deemed legally entitled to enter this country by our federal government, overnight were told they couldn't be let in, were detained, in some cases without access to attorneys, in some cases without access to their families. Some are still being detained as we sit here in the chamber today. This amendment would prohibit New York State entities, most notably the Port Authority, from participating in enforcing this unlawful executive order that has come from Washington. As everyone knows, the Port Authority has control over the New York City area airports, including, most notably, Kennedy Airport. There was a picture I was just looking at on my Twitter feed moments ago that showed Port Authority police prohibiting people from approaching the areas where this executive order is being enforced. As New Yorkers, it's our obligation to make sure that if something is going on that is so outrageous, that we not contribute to it, that we stand up and resist this effort, and we say not one penny of New York tax money should go towards enforcing this incredibly unlawful order from Washington. There should be no Port Authority personnel involved in this effort. There should be no Port Authority facilities allowed to be involved in this effort. And if there's a federal room or wherever they're detaining these people and the Port Authority somehow controls the climate or the electricity, that should be cut off too. It's time to take a stand. You know, the majority coalition is fond of passing a bill that says that we should deny NYPD protection for our courthouses because we may not agree with what's going on inside that courthouse. And my colleagues have no problem voting to impose that kind of a restriction. Well, I dare say this is a more serious issue, where in some cases legal Americans, people with green cards, are being held, who have done nothing wrong other than leave for a few days and try to come back. And overnight, they're suddenly prohibited from doing so. This is an unprecedented time. And as I mentioned at the outset, there are mainstream debates we can and have and will have again when we disagree on issues. But I think something this serious calls for us to unite as a chamber, to unite as New Yorkers, as a state that has always welcomed immigrants, as a state that welcomed my parents who came from another country, that welcomed many of our colleagues who themselves are immigrants, and say, not on our dime, not this time. I saw a great sign at one of these protests. It says, first they came for the Muslims, and I said, not this time, as opposed to the saying which says I did nothing until they came for you. So I asked my colleagues to join me in voting for this amendment and say with everything going on in this country, it's time we stand up and say, not this time. Thank you, my colleagues.